most exciting hockey scene in these parts in recent memory. It was the Jets hosting the Canadiens at the arena tonight in front of 15,500 patrons, and they were witness to a wild and woolly affair that produced no less than 12 goals. Here we go. We start midway through the first period. There's no score. Watch the bottom of your screen. Randy Carlyle moves in, strips the puck from Brent Gilchrist. That allows Pat Elnya to move in on Patrick Roy. Scores his 13th of the year. 1-0 Jets are on the board. Less than a minute later, more of the same. Dale Hawerchuk along the boards. He'll spot Randy Cunningworth, side of the net, wide open. 2-0 Jets just 57 seconds later. Now, Dale Hawerchuk came into this game with just 4 goals all season. His frustrations would continue in the second when he rings this blast off the far post. Hawerchuk, well, the poor guy can't buy a goal up to this point, wondering, when is this darn slump going to end? Well, not in the second period. It's now 2-1 Jets. Carlyle caught pinching at center ice. The speedy Russ Courtnell is gone. He'll get to it first. He scores on the second effort. It's now a 2-2 game. Still in the first, the Jets find themselves with the man advantage. Dave Ellett will put it to Hawerchuk. He spots Steen to Elenia in front of the net. He bulges the twine for his 14th of the year. It's 3-2 Jets. But before the second ends, Montreal power play. Stefan Richie back to Jurke Lume. He'll one-time it from the point. Save Brathiome. Rebound to Stefan LeBeau. 3-3 after two. Third period. Mats Naslund in the dressing room. 5-minute major. Here come the Habs. Short-handed. It's Walter to Chelios. His second shot beats the Bandit. 4-3 Habs. It's now 6-3 Montreal all over the Jets when something weird happens. Mark Kumpel winds up from the slot, and it starts a major Jet comeback, 6-4, and then a big one. Brent Ashton will put it in front to the slumping Hawerchuk, breaks it with his 5th of the season, 6-5 Jets. Then just over a minute and a half left in the third, huge goalmouth scramble. Greg Pozlowski will get credit for the tying goal, his 8th of the year. That tied the game at 6. They couldn't decide it in overtime. A great comeback by the Jets after spotting the Habs 3 goals. They score 3 in the third. They skate Hawerchuk with a goal and 2 assists. Jets record now 13-13-3. They have 29 points. They are 1 behind the third place Kings. They'll return to action Sunday afternoon when they take on the Flames for the second time in 5 days. Well, tonight's Dale Hawerchuk trade rumor has the Jets captain going everywhere at least once for almost everybody in the NHL. It's been another one of those weeks for the struggling Jets captain, but as Joe Pascucci reports, Hawerchuk and his teammates continue to take this part of the game in stride.
Dale Hawerchuk is going through the worst slump of his life. Because of that, plus his openly critical comments about Jets management last season, Hawerchuk has become the subject or concerned. Hawerchuk says he has not been affected by all the talk.
It doesn't bother me because I've gone through it now for a couple of years, and my only concern is get things going on the ice.
Meanwhile, in the dressing room, teammates are making light of the situation to ease any pressure that may be building up inside Hawerchuk.
You know, it's a little dig that you can give somebody. You're going to be here tomorrow. The guy's got a car deal in town. Maybe you'll scoop his car deal or stuff like that. Or that is more camaraderie between the players.
Randy Carlyle and Laurie Boschman can sympathize with what Hawerchuk is going through because both have been traded twice in their careers.
I think there's always that you're wondering if it's going to happen, you know, you're wondering if there's going to be a call coming through. I can honestly say the times that I've been involved in trade rumors and even recently, I think you just got to sort of let it brush by, you know, you can't let it concern you too much because, you know, it might affect your play.
It just takes a lot of hard work on his behalf and it's maybe some support from some people in the right direction, you know. You can't be critical of a guy that's trying, and when all you can do is give it your best and hope for the best.
Joe Pascucci, CKND Sports.
Well, there's a Smythe Division matchup underway tonight that the Flames will be keeping a close eye on. The first-place Oilers are home to the third-place Kings, who have a chance to jump into a second-place tie. It doesn't look like they'll do it at this point. Edmonton leading 4-2. That is in the third period of play. Now, the Penguins were going after their second straight victory under new head coach Craig Patrick, and they did so. 3-2 the final. Lemieux with the winning goal. He's now on a 17-game point-scoring streak. Now, the best in the Norris took on the worst in the Norris in the Motor City tonight. Minnesota and Detroit. First period. period, no score. Penalty to the North Stars just coming to an end. Federico feeds Steve Chase on. He hammers it. It trickles through, and it's a 1-0 Detroit lead. No more scoring until the second period. North Stars applying pressure. Watch bottom right of your screen. Bob Brooks skates in. His shot goes off the leg of Brian Bellows. It's his 19th, and it's 1-1 after two. Stars come close in the third. Basil McRae with a breakaway. Moving in on Hanlon, the backhander. Hanlon with a big save. Turned out to be a game saver because about a minute later, Corey is Salming from his own end ahead to Chason. Chason skates to center ice. He'll bang it in. Now watch Sean Byrne. He comes in. Final Red Wings unbeaten in their last four games. Stars are on a five-game losing streak. Now the Soviet exhibition tour that everybody's talking about continued in Calgary tonight. Flames hosting Kimmich, and they lose 6-3. Kimmich's next stop is Detroit on Sunday. There were three games played on the
championship as goalie Bob Esensa beat them for the fifth time in his brief NHL career.
It didn't take the Jets long to get going against the Flames. Just a minute 13 in, Doug Smale picks up his 11th of the season, getting wood on Dave Ellett's shot.
Thomas and Dave Ellett mix it up there to get it to the net, and I just tipped her in.
Calgary got its only goal of the game at the 16:50 mark of the first on the power play. Gary Suter with the point shot, and Joel Otto gets his stick down in front, tying the game at one apiece. After that, a couple of heavyweights get pumping. Shawn Cronin squaring off with Tim Hunter. Cronin with the first few shots, then Hunter comes through with some big lefts. The Jets with a good scoring chance late in the period. Mo Mantha with a shot from the slot. Wamsley gets a piece of it. When Jamie McCallum stops the puck at the goal line, the teams are tied at one after one. Second period, only two goals scored, both on the power play and both by the Jets. Dale Hawerchuk gets his second in two games as he gets a piece of Freddie Olsson's snapshot for a 2-1 lead.
I'm playing a little grittier. I'm getting more involved and... before, you know, I was getting a little frustrated, missing chances, and, you know, instead of going to the net and getting the goals the hard way, I was looking for the loose pucks, and now I'm just trying to get my nose in there and make the most of chances in tight.
The Jets build a two-goal lead on a pretty three-way passing play. Smale to Steen and out in front to a wide-open Pat Elnick with his fifth goal in six games, 3-1 Winnipeg after two. The Jets will salt away their third win this season against the defending Stanley Cup champs. Dave McIlwain gets his ninth when he steals a puck from Rick Wamsley.
He misplayed it behind the net and come out and tried to wrap it around. And he made the first save, actually, and I got the rebound and come right to him, and it went in the net. I guess the boys were ribbing me. Got Hawerchuk had a wide open net, but I had the blinders on, and I didn't see him at all coming in the slot.
Winnipeg taking it by a 4-1 final count. The Jets are now 7-3 against Smythe opponents, the best record in the five-team division. A confident bunch heading in against Calgary.
You come into the play against Montreal and Calgary twice in the four or five nights here. It's not just myself. Everybody bears down. They know it's a great club. Two Stanley Cup winners in the last couple of years. You know, we get to bear down and play. And also, we wanted to show the Winnipeg fans and the other people around the league that Winnipeg's not a doormat anymore.
We didn't do enough things right, and certainly Winnipeg deserves full credit for the effort they put forth. I think that Bob Murdoch's got them playing excellent hockey, and they're a threat in this division.
We played a man down quite a bit tonight, and that kind of hurt us. Took a lot of steam out of some of our players, and but 5-on-5, I thought we played pretty well.
During the regular season, you get every once in a while there's a game where it's a lot of penalties, and you know, it's a chance for especially teams to win a hockey game, and there's one the hockey game for them.
Well, the Jets are now only 1 point behind the Flames and the Los Angeles Kings, who are tied for second place in the Smythe division. And they're 7 points up on the Vancouver Canucks, who they will play their next two games, starting here on Wednesday night. Meanwhile, here's what happened elsewhere around the National Hockey League yesterday. The Kings in Quebec. Jim Benning will convert a Luc Robitaille pass, and it makes the score 1-1. Then John Tinelli, and it's 5-2 for the Kings. Robitaille will then get his second goal of the game, taking the feed from Bernie Nichols. The Kings will go on to an 8-4 victory. Off we go now to Chicago. The Canucks up 1-0 until Al Secord gets his first of two in the game. And after that, it was all Hawks. Denny Savard with the quick snapshot here, and it was 4-all. Greg Adams with the penalty shot, but Jacques Cloutier will come up with a big stop as the Hawks go on to beat the Canucks. The final in this one was 7-1. Let's get that straight for the Blackhawks. Off we go to Buffalo, the Caps in town. Uwe Kripp with the point shot. Dave Andrechuk the rebound, and it's 1-0 for the Sabres. Washington ties it up. Shorthanded, Dale Hutter with the shot. His own rebound scoring on Darren Pupa. That ties it up at 1-1. Second period, Phil Housley to Rick Vive. And the Sabres go on to win this one by a score of 4-3. Madison Square Garden, New York, Kelly Kissio scores on the nice effort. Net makes the score 1-1. But Philadelphia will go ahead to stay. Midway through the second period, Ilkka Sinisalo, the snapshot behind John Van Beesbrouck, 2-1. Then Terry Karkner will score, unloading the high shot past Van Beesbrouck. Flyers want to win it by a score. Tonight, including one in Montreal, which will be packed with emotion. Larry Robinson will be playing his first game at the Forum in something other than a Montreal jersey.
The Big Bird returned to the Forum this morning, his first regular season visit since signing with Los Angeles. He didn't skate, but watched as his former teammates practiced. He's tried to avoid thinking about his homecoming.
It's easy, and I found it very difficult playing against them just when I was in Los Angeles. And I don't think it's really going to hit probably until tonight when you first step on the ice, and then it'll probably hit home.
Robinson doesn't regret his move west. He could see the Canadiens moving in a different direction, and knew it was time for him to head a new way as well.
They made a decision to, to go with their young guys, and I made the decision because I felt that my presence here and my ice time with the Canadiens was getting less and less every year, and by going to Los Angeles, I was going to, do what I've liked to do all along, and that's to play hockey.
Robinson and his new team are second in the Smythe division, tied with Calgary, 3 points back of Edmonton. He says he now feels like an L.A. King.
Life does go on, and I've been trying to look at it that way. Not that I left here, but I started to have a new beginning.